How to detect dark mode in CSS and in JavaScript? How can we override it manually with a toggle button? And how do we save our setting in local storage? In this quick tutorial, we look into detecting dark mode in CSS and JavaScript, and then we create a toggle button with SVG to override the default behavior. Let's have a simple website with some text. By default, we set the text color to be black and the background color to be white. Implementing dark mode for this site with CSS is very simple. All you need to do is add the media query and set a condition. With this condition, we set that the following CSS statements are only true if the preferred color scheme is dark. Inside this media query, we can define the colors for dark mode. In this case, we flip the colors and set the text color to be white and the background color to be black. This will take the setting from the OS or the browser settings. By default, it comes from the operating system, but the browser can decide to override it. In Google Chrome, we can find this setting under Appearance. By default, it follows the device settings. What's great about the CSS solution is that if you change the setting while you're visiting the website, the styling will update automatically. This way, we can set a custom style for the body element or any other elements as well. It doesn't work in one case though. We can style what's inside an HTML canvas element with CSS. If we build up a game entirely from JavaScript using the Canvas API or Free.js, we must also set the colors for dark mode in JavaScript. We are going to look into this, and we are also going to discuss how to override this behavior from JavaScript. How can we create a toggle button that switches between light and dark modes? Before we learn how to handle dark mode in JavaScript, let's take a quick detour and see how to code a dark mode toggle button with SVG. Detecting dark mode is one thing, but we should also allow the user to manually toggle between light and dark modes. If you need a quick introduction to coding SVG icons, check out svgtutorial.com, where you can find many great examples from beginner to advanced levels. You can even see the examples we are learning in this tutorial. If you are new to SVGs, don't worry. These are very simple examples. So let's start coding this icon. We start with the SVG element. This will serve as a container for all the image elements. We set its size to 30 times 30. Then we add a circle for the core of the sun. For the circle element, we have to set the center coordinates of the circle and its radius. The center coordinates are both 15 and the radius is 6. Then we can set the color with the fill property. To set the color, we can use the current color property that takes over the current color from CSS. This will come in handy later when we toggle dark and light mode. The icon will switch colors automatically. Then we add the sun rays. We use the line element for this. For a line element, we have to set the starting and ending coordinates. We also set the stroke color with the stroke property, the stroke width to add thickness, and the stroke line cap property to make the end of the lines rounded. Now, once we have one ray, we can reuse the same line to draw the others. We can give this ray an ID and reuse it with the use element. For the reused elements, we can set a rotation. We set the rotation angle and the center of rotation. We want to rotate the rays around the center of the sun, so we set this coordinate to 15, 15. Then we increase the rotation by 45 degrees for each line. This way, we end up with a simple sun. Before we get to the moon icon, let's see how to detect dark mode in JavaScript. This can be useful when we build a game we did a couple weeks ago in the Gorillaz JavaScript game tutorial. Here we were drawing on an HTML canvas element with JavaScript. We set all the colors with JavaScript. If we want to support dark mode, we can set the colors based on the dark mode variable. But how do we detect if we are in dark mode? How do we set the value of this variable? Detecting dark mode in JavaScript is also very simple. Interestingly enough, this solution also depends on the CSS query selectors we used before. We can create a match media object with the same condition we used before in CSS. This method can check if the document matches a media query. We pass on prefers color scheme dark as an argument, the same condition we passed on in CSS. Then we can check the matches property of this object. If it is true, then we are in dark mode. We can save this into a variable, and later we can use this variable to decide the colors we should use when painting on the canvas element. This variable, however, doesn't get refreshed automatically when we switch between light mode and dark mode. We can define a listener that detects if the settings are changing. We can set a function that checks the matches property of the incoming object and decides if we just switch to dark mode or light mode. Now, if we set all the colors based on this dark mode variable, we can see that the game's appearance changes once we switch between light mode and dark mode in the OS settings. Before we get to how to override the default OS setting with a toggle button, let's see the other half of our toggle icon. Let's draw a moon. We start with an SVG element of the same size. Then we define a path inside of it. We can define a path element by setting its D attribute. In this attribute, we build a path from a series of commands. We start with a move to command to go to our initial position. This move to command consists of a letter M, and a coordinate, the starting position. Then we use an arc command to draw the outer arc of the moon. This command might look a bit scary because it has several properties, so let's see what we have. A command always continues the previous command. So this arc will start from the coordinates of the move to command. Commands also end with the coordinates of the endpoint. Here we set where the arc will end. The rest of the properties are about how to draw an arc from the starting point to the endpoint. The first two properties are the horizontal and vertical radiuses of the arc. In our case, we want to have the arc of a circle, so we set the same values for both. With the third argument, we can set a rotation. When both radiuses are the same, this property makes no difference. We can leave it at zero. Then we have the large arc flag. With this, we can decide whether to go on the long way or the short way to our end coordinate. You can see that we can reach the endpoint in multiple ways, even with the same radiuses. As we are drawing this moon, we will have two arcs. In the case of the first one, we go the long way. In the case of the second one, we will go the short way. The long arc flag is a flag, so the value can be either 0 or 1. Then finally, we have the sweep flag. This basically sets whether we are going clockwise or counterclockwise when we are drawing this arc. For the first arc, we set this to 0, and for the second, we set it to 1. Now that we have one arc, we set up the other one. Here we set the endpoint of this arc to the beginning, the same coordinates we used for the move to command. Then for the rest of the properties, we can use the same radiuses, but we have to change the large arc flag and the sweep flag to end up with a moon. Now that we have these two icons, how can we use them in a button to toggle light mode and dark mode in JavaScript? If we want to override the system or browser settings for dark mode with a manual switch, we can't rely on CSS media queries anymore. CSS media queries work for rendering the UI based on the settings, but we can't override them from JavaScript. Instead, we can define a new dark mode class and toggle it from JavaScript. In CSS, we define a class that will change the same settings the media query did before. Then in JavaScript, we can use the same logic we had before to get the default setting and then add or remove this class depending on dark mode. Now, how do we toggle this with a button? And how do we ensure that we get the same setting the next time the user opens the website? In our simple example, let's add a button element with an event handler. Then we move both SVGs inside this button and assign unique IDs for them. We will use these IDs to access them from JavaScript and toggle their visibility. For this button, we can also unset the default appearance in CSS, except for the cursor property. The cursor should remain a pointer. Now let's implement the event handler in JavaScript. Before doing so, first we get these two SVG elements by ID. Then we implement this function. This is a simple function that flips the dark mode property, toggles the dark mode class on the body element, and toggles the SVG icons. Now this works in a way that by default we still have the setting coming from the OS or the browser, but once we click this button, it will override it manually. One bug here is that the handler of the match media object will still trigger if we change the browser or OS setting while we are on the website. So you might want to ignore that once we manually switched the dark mode with this button. Or we can just remove this logic entirely, and then we can simplify the logic and check the initial setting in only one line. Now that we have this button and we can toggle dark mode and light mode back and forth, how do we ensure that the setting persists across multiple sessions? What if the user comes back later to our website and they expect to have the same settings where they left it? We can use the local storage to save this setting. Let's update our toggle dark mode function to save the dark mode property in local storage. This is a simple statement. We call the setItem method of local storage, and we set the variable name and the value of dark mode. Then let's see what should happen on page load. When we set the initial value of dark mode, first we check if the dark mode is already set in local storage. If it is, because we already visited the site before and we set the dark mode manually, then we can use this value. If local storage does not have this value, then we detect the OS or browser setting the way we did before with the match media object. With all this in place, we have a functionality that takes by default the dark mode setting from the browser or the OS. And once we override this setting with a toggle button, it will save it in local storage for the next session. If you want to learn more about SVGs, check out svgtutorial.com, where you can learn more about SVGs from beginner to advanced levels with many great examples. Or you can check the overview video I created earlier here on YouTube. If you want to use this behavior in a game, check out the Gorillaz JavaScript game tutorial, where we build up this entire game from scratch. It's a massive 2-hour tutorial where we go through drawing in a canvas element and the whole game logic with plain JavaScript. If you like this video, please subscribe and let me know in the comments below what would you like to see next. See you at the next one.